single peer. But if you're using it in a threatening manner, 9737.
My question is not going to threatening. It's going to an individual walking down the street with his hand on his weapon, and the police driving past that individual, or other citizens going past that individual. Not necessarily that the person is threatening him.
Okay, so to make sure I understand the case, no one would perceive the act as a threat, but just if you were walking down the street, resting your hand on the...
Could that be perceived as a threat, or is that, an illegal act?
If it is perceived as a threat, then it would be an illegal act. It could be illegal under the threatening exhibition of a weapon, 9737-19. It could also be disturbing peace, right? If it's creating an incident that is that's causing commotion, it is a, Your Honor, I take the point to be, it depends on the facts. And that's an important point. And I would clarify by saying, so do most of our, if not all of our criminal laws. When we talk about, is it self-defense to hit that person back or not? That's a factual determination.
Sorry.
It does depend.
So you can go into some of your arguments.
Your Honor, I think I covered everything I meant to cover. I appreciate the court's courtesy.
All right, Mr. Ross, very briefly.
To correct any defects that are in the field. in conclusion to the fact that he will declare that counts guilty to on this face unconstitutionally vague. He asks the court to extend the temporary restraining order until such time as this matter can be taken up by the legislature, either in a special session or when the legislature reconvenes in 2014.
All right, thank you, counsel. The court, again, the court previously entered a temporary restraining order. And that temporary restraining order is in effect until today. And the court now having listened to arguments from counsel, having entertained a motion for a further injunctive relief from the plaintiffs herein, the court will review all of the motions and briefs filed and responses from the state and will issue an opinion on this motion. However, the court would extend the temporary restraining order until Friday, July 12th, which is this week, and either on that day or prior to that day, the court will issue a ruling on the merits of the plaintiff's motion for injunctive relief. Any other questions?
Your Honor, make sure I'm following the report. The TRO is going to be extended until
Friday of this week.